Live from Arkansas's breaking news leader, Fox 16 News at 9 starts now.
If it would have touched down 2 seconds sooner, we'd have been gone.
Mother Nature pounds the south. In Arkansas, severe weather leaves people picking up the pieces after reports of a tornado tearing through the area. In other counties, heavy rains leave communities underwater. We have crews spread across the region tonight to bring you the very latest. Fox 16 severe weather coverage begins now.
And good evening, I'm Josh Berry. Some people won't have a home to sleep in overnight. Severe weather blew through parts of the natural state today. Tonight, the damage assessment begins. And we do have live team coverage across the state tonight covering the aftermath. Mitch McCoy will join us live from Ouachita County, but we begin tonight with Chief Meteorologist Jeff Baskin. And Jeff, we did have a very busy afternoon today covering this severe weather, but what are we seeing now? Is it safe to say we're out of the woods?
Well, parts of the state are out of the woods, but we still do have a severe weather threat, especially for parts of southern Arkansas as we go through the next few hours. That's because the warm air is still hanging on, but we've had colder air come on into most of central Arkansas, squashing the severe weather threat. What has not diminished is the flood threat, though, because very heavy rain will continue through the evening and overnight hours. The areas in the light green under a flash flood warning, which means that the flooding is expected in many areas. Under the warning area, and that does include the entire Little Rock metro area. We've had some heavy showers moving across most of central Arkansas during the afternoon into the evening hours, and a large area of heavy rain continues across western Arkansas, where it's just been raining all day. Northwest Arkansas reports of up to 9 inches of rain, where it's still coming down. So this is some serious rainfall. A lot of the creeks and streams are at bank full. We're going to get some flooding problems with the smaller creeks and streams and the smaller rivers, and then the larger rivers, especially a few days out after the rain is gone. And some stronger thunderstorms now coming across parts of southwest Arkansas, very close to that boundary dividing the warmer air from the cooler air to the north. And there is a tornado warning that's in effect for parts of northern Columbia County, as well as parts of Nevada County, mainly south and east of Roston. And that storm, as it moves into the cooler air, will begin to diminish, but there still is some rotation associated with that storm. And no warnings as far as severe thunderstorms or tornadoes across central Arkansas, but still some heavy showers moving across Little Rock area from Lake Maumelle westward. Just a solid area of moderate to heavy rain. Northern Arkansas, some light rain with some embedded heavier showers, and the rain continues even up into northwest Arkansas. And as we go into the evening hours, these storms will continue to move across parts of southern Arkansas, so we may be looking at still some residual severe threat, especially say south of the Camden area through the evening hours. This is all associated with a very large area of low pressure moving out of northeast Texas that's going to bring this area of rain right across central Arkansas tonight. Some very heavy rains, especially as we get towards midnight into the early morning hours, possibly a few heavier storms south into far southern Arkansas, northern Louisiana. A band of showers and thunderstorms moves into eastern Arkansas, southeast Arkansas as we get towards early Monday morning, with a few showers still rotating around our area of low pressure going into tomorrow morning. Then as that area of low pressure moves into Missouri, becoming breezy and colder, the wind really is going to pick up for your Monday. Here's the cooler air, which has been advancing southward all day. 70 was the high in Little Rock this morning, now down to the 40s. The cooler air has now reached Camden and Monticello, and that's why that severe threat is getting shoved down to the south. Very chilly across northern Arkansas with that rain. Temperatures in the 30s. Tonight, those temperatures may actually climb back up a little bit as that area of low pressure moves into the state, but then falls back again as we go into tomorrow, back into the 40s by noon. Rain coming to an end, but windy and turning colder, actually feeling more like winter next week. We'll talk more about that coming up in your 7-day forecast and give you the latest on radar.
All right, Jeff, thanks so much. Multiple businesses and homes are picking up the pieces after a suspected tornado went through the town of Bearden. That's in Ouachita County in South Arkansas. And it is important to know, we've been told there are no reported injuries at this hour. Fox 16's Mitch McCoy has followed those storms today. He's in Bearden tonight with the latest. Mitch, what are you seeing? What have people told you out there?
Josh, people tonight are just lucky to be alive. There are tree branches littering the streets all over this small town. Let me give you a perspective here. This is Main Street. You can see that they have this road completely shut down because there is just debris across the road. And also, let me show you this. This is a tin roof that was blown off of maybe a barn of some kind, maybe even this business right across the street. Now, let me show you this. This is just a yard. You can see that there's trash littering it everywhere, but here's the big thing right here. Look at this. This tree was completely uprooted and it is now laying on top of a house. You can see the soil. You can see there's water down where the tree used to be. And and if you can't see it, we're told that you can't see it. It is just a complete mud pile, and people tonight are just lucky to be alive. A Sunday afternoon in Bearden turned violent and scary. This cell phone video capturing what appears to be a funnel cloud coming through the main stretch of town.
We were outside watching it, and all of a sudden the wind picks up, and we see this cloud of dust and debris start flying.
Main Street full of debris, shingles from homes nearly everywhere.
We got a call, and next thing we know, we come home to this.
Ken's home was right in the path of the storm. It uprooted this tree in his backyard, and it fell onto his back porch.
Half of my house, the roof is caved in, and my storage bin is completely demolished.
Emergency officials say no one was injured.
Oh my God.
Now the people in this town are counting their blessings and reflecting back on something that could have been a lot more devastating.
If it would have touched down 2 seconds sooner, we would have been gone.
And just to reiterate, there's no confirmation that there was a tornado that touched down here. I was just at the command post, and the Ouachita County judge who is heading up that command post said that there's still a lot of work to be done. The National Weather Service will, of course, send out some survey teams to figure out just what happened here, if it was just straight line winds or if it was maybe a suspected tornado. But we've been seeing a lot of those cell phone videos of what appears to be a funnel cloud in the air. And Josh, on a side note, power has returned to at least half of Bearden here tonight.
And that definitely makes it a little bit safer for people traveling out on the roadways. But again, it is dark. We can tell from the video there that it is very hard to see out there. What are authorities saying about getting around town and the safety and what the plans are out there?
Well, the Ouachita County judge said that the command post is going to stay open all night long. And he said that it's very dangerous. It's even dangerous for some of the first responders. We're seeing a lot of sheriff's deputies, and we're seeing a lot of the city's police officers with spotlights and big heavy duty flashlights looking. And they're also going home to home to make sure that there's no injuries. It's dangerous for them because there's a lot of power lines still down. And that's why a lot of the roads and the streets here are still closed.
All right, Mitch McCoy live in Ouachita County for us tonight. Mitch, thanks so much. And we do have new video near Hampton where a reported tornado touched down. We're going to head to Calhoun County where we join Fox 16's Jonathan Rizel in just a bit. We do have a crew on the scene there, and we'll hope to bring you a live report later on in the show. And many people, of course, have taken to social media to show damage in their area. That's how we're getting a lot of these videos and a lot of these pictures tonight. Fox 16's Ken Bufa joins me now. And Ken, what have we seen online?
Well, Josh, you can see right here the sightings of damage and tornadoes popping up all over social media. Let's take a look at these photos posted online, most of them coming from Bearden and Hampton, like this photo here, that funnel cloud you heard Mitch McCoy talking about right here in the center of this photo. And this here is in Hampton. Now let's go to the next page where we have yet this damage. Now this was sent in earlier today, right around the evening when it was started to go to night. This is in Bearden where this, you can't really see it here, but a tree has fallen into this house, and on the other side, another tree hit the house on the roof on the side, and all this coiled all this coiled is this wire. These are power lines, so obviously very, very dangerous conditions as this storm damage moves through. Let's go to the next photo we have here. This is in Bearden. This was sent in by one of the officials there. You can see people coming together to try to help out. Bearden was one of the first places that reported a suspected tornado, and they say there's no injuries there, but a lot of roofs blown off. This is by officials. A lot of roofs blown off, a lot of shattered glass, and a lot of power outages that you can see in this photo here. And lastly, we're to go right here, and this is some flooding. This is in Mena, and if you can see it, I'm going to zoom in just a little bit. But that there is a bridge, and we've been getting a lot of flooding out of Mena with these heavy rains going through the natural state. But all these photos and much more are on our website. You can check that out at fox16.com. Again, be safe when you take these. They're not worth the photo, but we want to make sure you understand what kind of weather we're dealing with. Josh, we'll send it back to you.
To increase as people get out tomorrow and assess some of the damage. Let's take a look at some of the power outages right now as a result of these severe storms that blew through the state. This is what we're seeing from Entergy. At the moment, there's about 1,200 people that are without power tonight. In Bradley County, there's about 569 people without power, and several other counties have more than 100 people without power through their county. As Entergy gets out and starts assessing some of those numbers likely to decrease possibly overnight. Much of that work will be done tomorrow. And we are also getting reports of heavy flooding in the Polk and Scott County areas. Let's take a look at some of the video viewers have been sending in to us. At one point, officials in Scott County told us every road in the county was closed because of high water. Major roads in Yell County were also hit hard. And severe weather has extended all across the state. Officials have placed Benton County under a state of emergency. In Prairie Grove, the Illinois River is nearing its cresting stage. Tevin Wooten joins us live from Prairie Grove with more. Hey, Tevin.
Josh, we have been following this story all day long. We first met up with residents here in Prairie Grove, and they tell us they have lived here. We met up with a guy that's lived here for about 9 years. He says he's not too concerned yet. However, he has seen this river bridge, or he has seen this river reach some pretty impressive levels. And what we're looking at right now, I know it's hard for you to see, but I can tell you, you see a few cars starting to pass here. About a foot, 2 feet, 2 feet under that, that's where the Illinois River is running, right into the Highway 62 River Bridge. The police have been monitoring this all night long, and so have neighbors who live in the area.
Well, when it rains, usually the water just runs down the ditch over there and goes into the river. But when it rains 5, 6, 7, 8 inches, we wind up with what you see behind us.
And I can tell you now what you saw behind me, at least what you saw behind that gentleman there. You saw the Illinois River creeping slowly up to his backyard. He said he's going to monitor it. He's not too certain what's going to happen, but he does have flood insurance in case something bad were to go wrong. Meanwhile, here in Prairie Grove, with the National Weather Service calling, the Illinois River is suspected to reach impressive levels or just exceed the record amount of levels ever recorded along the Illinois River in Tahlequah. Here in Prairie Grove, police and county Sheriff's Office workers, our deputies, are monitoring the Highway 62 River Bridge just to make sure this road is not shut down, because if it were shut down, the reroute to get out of town would be about a half an hour away. Reporting live in Prairie Grove, Tevin Wooten, Fox 16 News. Josh.
And definitely some important information for people who happen to be traveling there through the area. But Tevin, I'm curious, is there a timetable for when they expect this river to crest and when it may start going back down and start clearing up for them there?
You know, just about 20 minutes ago, we had a deputy here shining a spotlight out into the water, so I don't think they expect it to go down anytime soon. They are monitoring it, possibly cresting tonight, and then tomorrow morning they're going to reassess and see what needs to be done following what happens here tonight.
And we'll continue to follow it. Tevin Wooten live in Northwest Arkansas for us tonight. Tevin, thanks so much. And Arkansas isn't the only state dealing with Mother Nature. At least 11 people have died after deadly tornadoes ripped through Texas. Our own Will Carr is in Rowlett, Texas, with the latest on the recovery efforts and the potential for more storms.
It sounded like a freight train coming through.
Devastation across Texas today after several tornadoes, including a powerful EF4, ripped through the northern part of the state.
We still don't know the 100% extent of damage. We've done a primary search last night and a secondary search, but we're going to go back and search each structure to make sure that we don't miss anything.
Crews across the state are focused on cleanup and recovery after battling deadly storms and heavy rains and flooding. And if that wasn't enough, the western part of the state facing blizzard conditions.
My message is please stay home. If we need help, we will call you. I promise we'll call for help. We've got all the help we need right now. We don't need extra people around. It really hampers our ability to do our job.
Texas Governor Greg Abbott declaring a state of disaster for four counties as the number of people injured continues to rise.
We pray and support those who have lost a family member. We pray and support those who have had their homes destroyed and their lives turned upside down.
It's just sad. It's hard to see all these people's livelihood gone. You know, cars destroyed, flipped over in front of houses, and it's just hard to see. So it's just unbelievable to me.
The heavy storm system's making its way across the country, with Missouri also facing deadly storms and flooding. As the damage continues to be uncovered and the cleanup continues, Texas still isn't out of the woods with flash flood warnings throughout the night. For the Arkansas Storm Team, I'm Will Carr. Back to you.
Well, thanks, and we will continue to follow weather throughout the night. You can get the latest on Fox 16 Good Day tomorrow morning and on our website at fox16.com. And straight ahead, we continue our severe weather coverage. We will have more live reports coming up, and a community tries to recover tonight after a possible tornado rips through the area. We head back to Washington County coming up. But first, Chief Meteorologist Jeff Baskin is tracking the skies, the latest on the severe weather coverage and what we can expect in the next several days when Fox 16 News at 9 returns.
You're watching Fox 16 News at 9 with Josh Berry, Sports with Chase Shannon, and Meteorologist Matt Peterson. Weather to plan your day with Fox 16 Chief Meteorologist Jeff Baskin.
And Jeff, a lot of damage out there from, especially in the southern parts of the state, from severe weather, possibly tornadoes. What are we looking at in the next couple of days, really?
Well, the good news is that the tornado threat is gradually diminishing. We've had some cooler air move southward across much of south central Arkansas, so that threat has diminished. But a flood threat is going to continue through the overnight hours into early tomorrow morning. Very heavy rain. We've already had some serious flooding across parts of northwest and western Arkansas, and that's likely to continue. Check out these rainfall amounts. These are the rainfall amounts just since midnight. We've had actually more than that if you count the rain from yesterday. Almost 6 inches of rain in Fayetteville, but in Benton County, we've had reports of as much as 9 inches of rain, about 5 inches around Fort Smith, Mena over 6 inches of rain. That's why all the flooding problems across parts of Scott County with 5 to 7 inches of rain, and coming up in about 2 inches of rain across parts of central Arkansas. Look at Russellville, already up to 5.37, and we're not even close to being done with the rainfall. Flash flood watch is in effect for all of the state, but actually we have flood warnings now in effect for much of central Arkansas. The severe threat, specifically the tornado threat, now limited to far southern Arkansas, pretty close to the Louisiana border. That's where we still have some warmer air in place. The cooler air has moved pretty far to the south, and that diminishes the severe threat. However, we do have a couple of tornado warnings for parts of southwest Arkansas, and does include portions of Nevada County for a cell that's been moving northward. But as that cell has moved north into Nevada County, it's encountered some cooler air. Temperatures in Camden only in the 50s. So as it's crossed over that boundary, the circulation, well, it's no longer reaching the ground. So the severe threat associated with that storm is diminishing, but still more of a tornado threat towards the Louisiana border in the warmer air. Right now across Little Rock area, a little break from the rain, not going to last long though, as we have another band of heavy rain moving on in from the south, and then you get west of Lake Maumelle towards Hot Springs Village. It's just a solid area of rain. Notice these showers moving towards the north. Some areas just with these heavy showers that have moved through from time to time, 1 to 2 inches of rain right across the metro area back into Sheridan, and then as you get into western Arkansas, we've had some very heavy rain, especially northwest. This area in yellow indicating possibly up to 9 inches of rain near the Bentonville area, Fayetteville, 4, 5, even 6 inches of rain. That heavy rain along the I-40 corridor back into Yell County over towards Waldron and Mena, where we've had some flooding problems, and still some heavy rain coming on down. Several more hours of rain to go as we have a strong area of low pressure forming across eastern Texas, which is going to wrap up and move across the state for tonight. Notice a large area of rain going all the way back back past Dallas. So it's a large area of rain. It's going to take a while for it to get through. We've had some colder air come on behind that system. Temperatures in the 30s and 40s on the north side. And then in the warm side, temperatures in the 70s. Yeah, that's what helped to really drive some of that severe weather, is that strong temperature contrast. Northern Arkansas, you know what? A few degrees colder really would have been a mess with ice or possibly snow. Temperatures, though, in the mid-30s, keeping it all rain. Mid-40s across much of central Arkansas after highs near 70 this morning. But now that cooler air is pushed to the south. Actually, Camden in the cooler air down to 50 degrees. El Dorado down to 66. 60 in Monticello. Temperatures down about 15 degrees over the last hour, indicating that front now is just about to the southernmost row of counties close to the Louisiana border. And south of that area is where the tornado threat will persist for the next few hours. Right now in Little Rock, 47 degrees, winds north at 14 miles per hour. And as we take a look at our forecast satellite and radar, notice that heavy rain moving across the state through the overnight hours, some heavy showers right into tomorrow morning, but finally diminishing by about midday, then breezy and colder behind that area of low pressure. At least we dry out as we go into the middle part of the week. However, likely some pretty serious flooding problems along the major rivers as we go into later in the week, even well after the rain stops. Those bigger rivers, after they drain those tributaries, they start to rise. So as we take a look at tomorrow morning, showers around, very breezy. Temperatures actually dropping into the 40s. Very windy. Wind gusts to about 40 miles per hour. The wind diminishes as we go into the evening hours. Temperatures dropping into the low to mid 40s. Feeling a lot more like late December, early January as we get to New Year's, with low temperatures generally in the 30s and highs in the 40s and 50s. You'll actually need those winter coats again.
16 News at 9. Covering Sherwood, Maumelle, Little Rock, and all of Central Arkansas.
In a breaking news update, we are learning more information on a shooting at a liquor store in Little Rock that happened Saturday night. The shooting happened last night around 8 on 12th Street. 31-year-old Steve Williams and 29-year-old Tyrone Williams were shot several times in the stomach. Both, we're told, are in stable condition at the hospital. Police, however, are still looking for the person responsible. In a Fox 16 crime alert, Little Rock police hope to find someone who robbed a gas station. Investigators say it happened at the Shell Superstore on Cantrell near I-430 Saturday morning. Police say the guy lifted his shirt to show the clerk he had a gun in his waistband. The clerk handed over money. Officers believe he's around 20 years old and about 5'10". Anyone with information is asked to call police. In this week's Arkansas's Most Wanted, U.S. Marshals need your help locating this man, 26-year-old Terrence Knowlton. Knowlton's wanted for theft and burglary charges and several other offenses. If you have any information that could lead to an arrest, you're asked to call the U.S. Marshals Office. That number is there on your screen. An anonymous tip could earn you a cash reward. In a Fox 16 News update, police, along with federal officials, are investigating a possible arson case at the childhood home of President Bill Clinton. Authorities say they got a call around 3 Friday morning to the historic site. They say a fire had been started at the back of the house and went up. Firefighters say they believe this is a case of arson because they smell heavy accelerant. Investigators seem to believe juveniles may be responsible. Coming up, heavy rains hit the natural state. Plus, we are live in Bearden, where a possible tornado ripped through the area. A survey of that damage straight ahead. Plus, we check back in with meteorologist Jeff Baskin at the latest on our severe weather coverage when Fox 16 News returns.
We're watching Fox 16 News at 9. Covering Conway, Malvern, Little Rock, and all of Central Arkansas.
The town of Bearden picking up pieces tonight after a possible tornado rips through the area. Continuing our team coverage of severe weather striking the natural state, Mitch McCoy has been in Ouachita County all night. And Mitch, luckily no injuries to report, but there's definitely some significant damage out there. Is that right? And a train.
Yeah, absolutely. And we also have a train going by, so we apologize about that. And let's tell, since we talked to you at 9 o'clock, we found more debris. This is a garage door that looks like it came completely off of wherever this garage door was originally attached. And I don't know if our photojournalist Blake can go over and look at some of this damage here. This is a tree that completely was uprooted during these powerful winds or this possible tornado. You can see that it is completely out of the ground and it is now laying on this person's house. Nobody was injured. Thankfully, they weren't at home at the time, but their back roof is caving in a little bit. Their porch has been destroyed. And the sense here is that they were able to have like a code red text alert through this community. So they knew that a strong storm was coming, but when it hit hard.
We were outside watching it, and all of a sudden the wind picks up, and we see this cloud of dust and debris start flying.
And just to recap exactly what's going on here in Berradine, they know that there is a lot of damage throughout this community. The storm hit the Berradine lumber mill. Several stores and homes have damage. Roofs have damage to them. This roof, if you remember, if you weren't joining us for Fox 16 News at 9, right at the top of the hour, we showed you this roof right here that was completely blown right off. And it's now laying in this person's yard. So right now, this is Main Street. Police have it completely shut down because there's just debris everywhere, and they're trying to get a handle on it. And we're hearing some thunder. We're also seeing some lightning. It is starting to sprinkle just a little bit here. So that, I'm sure, is not going to help any efforts in trying to clean up some of this damage. And police are also going door to door, making sure that residents are safe and okay after these powerful storms ripped through. But the American Red Cross is also on the scene here, Josh.
And Mitch, we've talked about the significant damage that we've seen out there and what you're seeing out there and what authorities are telling us. But for there to be no injuries out there, is that indicative of any preparedness or warnings that may have been in place out there for the people that live in the county?
Absolutely. I was able to talk with the Ouachita County judge, and he said that he received a text message. The county has a code red text alert system, and he said that he received that text message in advance before the storm came through the county. But he said that we're in the early stages of figuring out if there was any early warning system that may have helped, but it's evident here that warning system did help in this case, because there are no reported injuries right now, and that is very good news. Especially, I mean, when you see stuff like this just laying in the yard and you have a huge, large tree completely uprooted, it is evident that early storm system helped here tonight.
All right, Mitch McCoy joining us live in Ouachita County. Mitch, thanks so much. And in Calhoun County, reports of downed trees and power lines are being reported to the sheriff's office. They've already had to cut and remove fallen trees from roadways. Authorities are estimating 150-yard wide path of fallen trees. Over at the Highland Industrial Park, 6 railroad boxcars were blown right off the tracks during the storms, leaving one blocking part of Highway 203. Park President Gene Hill says the railroad cars were fortunately empty.
What we do here at this facility is we store empty rail cars for, you know, a variety of companies. So 99% of the cars out here in the industrial park are empty cars, and that's the case with these.
Now, Hill says a rail car recovery team will arrive in the morning from Shreveport to help remove the fallen cars. Roof damage was reported on some of the plants inside the park, but officials say they will have to assess full damage come morning time. And of course, damage assessment and what people are seeing out there will be the story tomorrow. But immediately, we're talking about heavy amounts of rain, flooding, and its implications throughout the rest of the week.
Well, flooding is going to be the main concern going through tonight and tomorrow morning. We've already seen a lot of rain across parts of the state. We've already had some fairly serious flooding problems, especially across parts of western and northwest Arkansas. And as we go into central Arkansas later on this evening, we are going to get into more of a flood situation. There is a flood warning out, a flash flood warning out for most of central Arkansas, includes the entire Little Rock metro area. A lot of those creeks and streams are going to overflow. There's going to be some roadways where there's too much water on them, and they may become impassable. And just remember, don't drive across flooded roadways. You get in trouble very quickly if you attempt to do that. You don't know how deep the water is. You don't know if it's moving. And in some cases, you might not even realize that the road has been washed out. So it's not worth taking that sort of risk. Temperatures this evening have really dropped across parts of South Central Arkansas. Look at Camden down to 50 degrees, 50 in Pine Bluff. The front is through Monticello, and actually the front has now reached El Dorado at 62 degrees, and that is squashing the severe weather threat farther towards the south as far as any tornado risk or severe storm. So as we take a look at the radar view, some stronger storms across parts of South Central Arkansas, but we don't have any warnings. And across northern and especially western Arkansas, moderate to heavy rain just keeps on coming down. We did have the tornado warning in effect for parts of Nevada County that was allowed to expire at 9:30 as the storm moved across the front into colder air and quickly weakened. Some heavy rain moving across the Little Rock area right now. More showers coming up from the south and a large area of rain west of the metro area that's going to overspread most of Little Rock as we go towards the next couple of hours. Some of that heavier rain now from Jacksonville along 67, 167, Sherwood, North Little Rock, over towards parts of Highway 10. As we get into North Central Arkansas, some heavy rains all across the I-40 corridor from Conway all the way over towards Clarksville and Fort Smith, where there's already been some heavy rains, many areas over 5 inches of rain so far. And this is going to continue as we go through the overnight hours, with the heaviest of the rain beginning to push into Central Arkansas as we go through the overnight hours, and then into northern and eastern Arkansas as we go into tomorrow morning, with those showers gradually coming to an end. We'll have more on this coming up in just a few minutes.
All right, Jeff, thanks so much. And of course, a lot of the images and videos that we've seen and been able to share with folks today have been a result of social media and people sharing them on our sites, and video of what's believed to be actual tornadoes touching down on the ground. You've been covering it. Yeah, you've been covering it all day long.
Josh, you're exactly right. All these photos have been coming in on Fox16.com and on our Facebook. Check out this one. This is from a viewer named Dominic. And if you can see right here underneath that home, there's a car. He said this is his grandmother's house, and you can see very apparently that the house has been lifted and put onto the car. Now let's go to another photo that Dominic has taken, and this is what he saw. This is the funnel that he said he saw in Hampton, that damage going on his grandmother's house that you just saw. A lot of people seeing this funnel or reported tornado in that area. And last but not least, better view right there of that photo. Last but not least, this one's out of Potter, Arkansas. And you can see on the top and on the bottom. The top is the before photo of before the severe weather. In the bottom, that's all the flooding they're dealing with. So you can see how much this heavy rainfall is flooding certain areas of the natural state. And all these photos, again, on Fox16.com. And if you're taking these, make sure you're safe.
Sure.
But all of these on our website, and obviously a lot of damage from this severe storm.
And the effects of heavy amounts of rain for sure. And let's take a look at some of the power outages that we're seeing across the state. This is from Entergy. This is what we're seeing right now on their power outages website. 1,700 customers are without power right now. And of course, some of those are centered around in Bradley County. And again, Nevada County has about 446 people without power. And so some of those are likely to increase. Some of them could decrease throughout the night as Entergy gets to work on them. Again, that number is just about 1,500 people without power. Now, we will continue to follow the weather throughout the night. You can get the latest on Fox 16 Good Day tomorrow morning and on our website at fox16.com. We'll be right back after this.
You're watching Fox 16 News at 9, covering Sherwood, Maumelle, Little Rock, and all of Central Arkansas.
Well, I'm here with KARK Chief Meteorologist Keith Monahan, and when we have severe weather, Fox 16 and KARK 4 team up and we provide severe weather coverage from both of us.
That's
that
right.
Way we combine resources.
We call that the Arkansas Storm Team. It basically gives us the ability to have a lot of meteorologists involved. We have 7 meteorologists that can be here, be in the studio, and it's not just the two of us or 3 meteorologists on the air. It's a lot of folks doing some background research, looking at information from the ham radio network as well as National Weather Service reporting sites to bring you the very latest information. In fact, we went on the air before 4 o'clock today with one of about a half a dozen supercells.
Well, yeah, actually, I'm going to rewind the radar. I'm going to take us back 6 hours, and this is what it looked like just before 4 o'clock today, and across southern Arkansas, we had numerous cells starting to develop. These were becoming supercells, or in other words, rotating thunderstorms. And at one point, we had about half a dozen of them. We had the one coming out of Hempstead into Nevada County. We had one over Columbia County. This was the one that looks like it hit, that was the one that hit Bearden, the one over Calhoun County, and we also had one just to the west of Fordyce and another one that was just coming into Union County, crossing over the Louisiana border. So we had numerous thunderstorms capable of producing a tornado. At one point, I believe we had just in our area, we had four tornado warnings at once, or actually four storms that had prompted tornado warnings.
Exactly. And when you include south and southwest Arkansas in a different forecast area, there was three or four additional warnings at that time. So certainly a very busy afternoon. This storm is the same storm system, fortunately not quite as strong as the one that plowed through north central and northeast Texas late last night and earlier today.
Yeah, fortunate that we didn't have to deal with that. Yesterday, there was the conditions in place for strong tornadoes over Texas. And today, well, we could have gotten a couple of strong tornadoes. We didn't, and that was good. We got a couple of smaller tornadoes, which, you know, any damage is bad, but the way the setup was today really could have been a lot worse.
Well, fortunately, we got that colder air pretty far south in the viewing area to really inhibit the outbreak of severe weather across the state.
That was really the limiting factor. Once that cold air got in place, that pretty much brought an end to the severe threat. Now areas like Bearden over towards Hermitage in the cold air now, it's kind of chilly out there, and that's good news because that is means the severe threat as far as a tornado threat has come to an end, but of course we'll be watching the flood threat overnight into tomorrow.
That's going to continue through tomorrow.
Okay, all right, we'll be back in just a little bit.
Now, sudden death sports with Chase Shannon, powered by North Point Cars.
We're down to our final 2 weeks of the NFL's regular season, and after 2 months of limbo, Ryan Mallett is back on the gridiron. The former Hog starting for the Baltimore Ravens today, and boy, did he take advantage. Mallett tossing for 274 yards and a touchdown in Baltimore's 20-17 win over Pittsburgh, completely outdueling Ben Roethlisberger, who had tossed 2 interceptions and 0 touchdowns. Mallett says he's glad to be back.
I want to thank the Ravens organization for bringing me in and giving me a shot, giving me a workout, and Coach Harbaugh. And I mean, just being here I don't even know what to say right now. It's an emotional time, but it's fun.
And up in Buffalo, Darren McFadden and the 4-10 Dallas Cowboys taking on the Bills, and McFadden with another nice outing. He's been a lone bright spot for the boys all season long, and now he's closing in on his second 1,000-yard rushing season of his pro career. Today, the Oak Grove High School product rushing for 99 and heads into next weekend's finale, needing only 3 more to pass the milestone. Oh, and by the way, DMAC gets a $300,000 bonus if he gets there. A big day for another local product last night. Despite losing 55-52, Tulsa's Jeremy Brady would be named the Independence Bowl's defensive player of the game after 6 total tackles and a crucial interception return for 43 yards that would set up a Golden Hurricane touchdown. We'll hear from him next on The Final Score with Westmore. And speaking of the final score, in just minutes, the Pine Bluff Zebras in studio. Bobby Boulding and company talking about their back-to-back Class 6A state championships and what it would take to earn their stripes at War Memorial Stadium once again a couple weeks ago. You won't want to miss that. And a huge week of college hoops ahead for all of our Division I teams. Arkansas, A-State, UCA, and the Little Rock Trojans, all tipping off conference play at some point in the next 6 days. The Trojans have been one of the best stories so far in the nation this season as they've raced out to a 10-1 start through non-conference play. Assistant head coach Wes Flanagan in studio, and we'll talk about their goals heading into Sun Belt play. He'll join our Wes Moore. All that and plenty more right here on Fox 16 immediately following this newscast. First, we'll be right back.
And with one final look at the weather, Jeff, I guess with all the damage that we saw across the state and the southern portion of the state, just fortunate there were no injuries with any of these, at least that were serious and we've been told about.
Well, very fortunate. I think people took heed to the warnings, and that always helps too when people take those warnings seriously. The severe weather threat has diminished quite a bit for most of Arkansas, although there still is a tornado risk near the Louisiana border, and from the Louisiana border south, a tornado watch likely extended until early tomorrow morning. But most of the state now under a flash flood warning, meaning flooding is imminent or occurring. Lots of roads likely will have some flooding problems for tomorrow morning, as well as some creeks and streams overflowing their banks. So be very careful traveling for tomorrow morning. Even though the rain may be letting up, we may be looking at some serious flooding problems in some spots, especially across parts of western and northwest Arkansas, where we still have some of the heaviest rain. Some heavy rain now coming across parts of southern Arkansas into Union County around El Dorado and into parts of Calhoun County. That's all circulating around a big area of low pressure moving out of eastern Texas, and that's keeping us wet through the overnight hours. We do begin to dry out as we get towards midday tomorrow, but very windy, some gusts up to about 40 miles per hour.
Okay, thanks, Jeff, and thank you for joining us for Fox 16 News at 9. Final score with Wes Moore is next. Have a good night.